hospitals, urgent care, and specialty clinic locations across Colorado. UC Health celebrates high school football players and fans. They live an extraordinary life. UC Health, the official athletic trainer for Cherokee School District. Spectators, we thank you for attending tonight's contest. For the safety of everyone, we please ask that you maintain social distancing in the stands and wear masks for the duration of tonight's contest. Overland High School and the Cherokee School District thank you for your cooperation in this matter. Overland and Cherokee Trail are proud members of the Colorado High School Activities Association. This association believes high school athletics to be a vital part of the total educational program and conducts competitive activity for the many benefits which are derived by spectators and participants alike. The high ideals we hold in this regard can only be realized where there is respect for the effort and integrity of all game officials, coaches, and players. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Stutler Bowl, home of your Overland Trailblazers. Our principal, Alicia Armour, athletic director, Carl Buck, and the great students of our school would like to welcome each of you to this evening's contest between our Overland Trailblazers and the Cherokee Trail Cougars.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
It is now time to introduce both teams, starting with the visiting Cougars from Cherokee Trail. Starting for the Cougars, number 2, Jane Burke. Number 11, Jack Pierce. Number 13, Alex Sturgis. Number 14, Jaden Levine. Number 19, Noah Boyer. Number 21, Nate Gay Jr. Number 52, Ryan Kawashima. Number 58, Chris Parker. Number 59, Jackson Cool. Number 64, Noah Aramio. Number 70, Travis Gray. The head coach for the Cougars is Joe Johnson. And now for your starting lineup for the Overland Trailblazers. Number 5, Jaheim Roper. Number 6, Rashawn Stewart. Number 7, Damaris Davis. Number 8, Malachi Sims. Number 11, Keanu Roberson. Number 13, Sir Joyner. Number 19, Scooter Thomas. Number 22, Khalil Ali Fisher. Number 33, Christopher Lindsay. Number 56, Brett Stonebreaker. And number 58, Rashad Leslie. The head coach for the Trailblazers is Kyle Reese. The referees for tonight's contest are John Johnick, John Johnson, Steve Burns, Matt Thompson, and Deb Schonger. Sit down. you will please rise and lead your hats and pay tribute to our country by the playing of our national anthem.
And we welcome you to the Stutler Bowl in Greenwood Village, Colorado. It is Centennial League football and the final Friday night of the regular season on tap this evening. We've got a matchup between the visiting Cherokee Trail Cougars and the host Overland Trailblazers. Hi, everybody. Glad you're with us. Chris Sylvester and JP Hiraoka on hand here on Cherry Creek TV on YouTube. This unique and shortened high school football regular season culminates this weekend with the playoff brackets and matchups coming out on Sunday. Luckily, both of these programs have avoided cancellations through the six-game slate. Cherokee Trail, after an 0-2 start, they have reeled off three straight victories, and with another tonight, they expect to be in the postseason next week. Overland in the midst of a rebuild with first-year head coach Kyle Reese. They haven't won a game this fall, but they put up 39 points in a rivalry loss to Smoky Hill last week, and if they'd like, they could schedule a seventh game next week against another local program that isn't in the postseason. So, JP, as we get ready for kickoff in a year where there was a lot of back and forth on whether or not to play this fall, we have reached the final weekend of the regular season.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think a lot of people would see this matchup as maybe uncompetitive with such a favorite in the Cherokee Trail Cougars. You know, Overland is 0-5 on the season. Cherokee Trail looking to make the playoffs and a top 10 team in Colorado. But there's a lot to like for Overland in this matchup. They kept Jaden Levine to just under 100 yards last year.
Off we go on a Friday night from the Stutler Bowl. And Cherokee Trail will have the football first, the kick return by Gabe Walker, the senior linebacker there on special teams. He takes it out to the 35-yard line, and that's where the Cougars will set up shop. Three straight victories for Cherokee Trail after their first 0-2 start since the 2009 season, in large part to their defense, which we'll see in a little bit, but this offense has been pretty good too.
Yeah, sure. They're scoring a ton of points this year. I mean, they're coming off of a barn burner with Grandview in which they scored 21 points in the first half. So let's see what they can do against an Overland defense that struggles this year.
Jaden Levine at the controls for Cherokee Trail. And the screen pass is complete, but not much doing for Noah Greer, the team's leading receiver last week. He had four catches for 86 yards in the five-point win, and he's tripped up after a gain of two.
Yeah, and one thing to note tonight, Chris, if you're looking for number 81, Sam Hart, the big tight end for Cherokee Trail, one of the big offensive weapons they have, he's not actually going to be playing tonight, sidelined with an injury. So we'll see how that shakes up for them.
Nate Gay, the junior tailback, lost the football as he crossed the 40-yard line. The officials will say the knee hit the turf before the ball came loose. And he's taken down about a yard shy of a Cherokee Trail first down, and it'll bring up a third and short for the Cougars. Nate Gay, 21 carries, 64 yards, couple of touchdowns last week in the win over Grandview. at Legacy Stadium.
Yeah, he's been so productive as of late here.
Four receivers for Levine. He turns and gives it away. Gay stretching left, and he'll be stopped right near a first down.
Hand off to number 21, Nate Gay Jr.
And already an interesting decision going to come up here for head coach Joe Johnson in this Cherokee Trail roster.
The officials will move the chains. Fresh set of downs for Cherokee Trail. They convert on third down. First time they try here in the opening quarter. Final weekend of the regular season. The Centennial League will be decided tomorrow as Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek meet. Levine throwing on the run, and Nate Burke, the senior receiver, can't hold on. Now Jaden Levine, 29 career touchdown throws in his illustrious high school career. Two-year starter here at Cherokee Trail and playing in his final high school regular season game this evening.
Yeah, I mean, let's hope that he can put up a big outing in his final high school appearance.
6'3", 185-pound senior. Toss play. And right to the midfield stripe that goes. It's a run of 5 yards, and it's Nate Gay, the junior, 5'10", 180-pound tailback, a guy that ran for more than 700 yards as a sophomore last year. And when these two teams met in 2019, he carried 14 times for 86 yards.
Right, and when we had caught up with Cherokee Trail early in the season and watched them play, he wasn't quite having the season he did in 2019, but here in the last couple weeks really picked it up and scored a lot of touchdowns and ran for quite a few yards for this Cherokee Trail team.
Third down again. Pierce can't hold on. And so Levine misfires. Sir Joyner, the sophomore defensive back in coverage for Overland. And Joe Johnson will send out his punt team, so a stop to start the game for the Overland defense.
Yeah, exactly what you're looking for if you're Overland. This Cherokee Trail team got off to such a hot start last week, such an explosive offense. Any sign of halting them early is going to bode really well for them moving forward in this football game.
Jaheim Roper dropping deep to receive the punt, and he'll let it go. It bounces inside the five, and the official will say that went into the end zone for a touchback. So we'll get our first look at a Trailblazer offense fresh off a 39-point performance, albeit in a loss last week in the battle for the wagon wheel. That was 8 nights ago here at the Stutler Bowl last Thursday night. Smoky Hill beat Overland. And I'm going to talk to Kyle Reese, first-year head coach of the Trailblazers, earlier this afternoon. And despite the loss, he really felt like his team made a big leap forward last week.
Yeah, he sees his team really improving from the beginning of the football season, really just simplifying things, running the ball a lot more, and they think that they're finding a lot more success with that. Obviously, he's a first-year head coach, so in the middle of not being able to have his players practice as much this year, really difficult to develop any kind of continuity, simplify it down a little bit, and they're getting more success from that.
Kai Ilela, the signal caller for Overland, the 6'3", 190-pound senior, misfires. And he was looking for Ishmael Cici, who caught 3 touchdowns last week. Well, Ilela playing in one of his final games at the high school level. He dropped to throw 42 times last week, 18 of 42, 262 yards, 6 touchdowns, and 2 interceptions.
Yeah, just an incredible week.
First possession for Overland, and they'll give it to Humphrey on the fly sweep. He hits the edge and spins across the 25-yard line. See where the officials spot the football. Spotted at the 27, so it'll bring up third down and 3 for the Trailblazers. Tonight, the 13th all-time meeting between Cherokee Trail and Overland. The Cougars lead the all-time series 10-2. First meeting back in 2008. Cougars have won 5 in a row over the Trailblazers, who last beat Cherokee Trail in their last winning season, 2014. So it's 3rd and about 3 here for Overland. And the Trailblazers run the football, and it'll pick him up the first down. Khalil Ollie Fisher, the 6-foot junior tailback, gains close to 7 yards on the 3rd down run. And the Trailblazers pick up a fresh set of downs.
And look for this Overland Trailblazers team to run their backfield by committee. They've got so many players with talent back there. Christopher Lindsay, Khalil Ali Fisher, who we just saw. We've already seen Jameel Humphrey take a couple of snaps back there. So really, they like to get a lot of different players involved and give them different looks at it.
Yilela throwing, and the catch made. That's CeCe across the 40-yard line, brought down at the 42. Ishmael CeCe had a big breakout game a week ago. He's just a sophomore, 5 catches, 91 yards, and 3 touchdowns. He figures to be quite the receiver by the time it's all said and done in his Overland High School career, but he's a real building block for Kyle Reese and company moving forward.
Sure, he's got to be the future for this Overland team, and this is an Overland school with 12 sophomores on the roster, 5 freshmen, so it's not that they're not without youth. They really have a lot of players up and coming that should bode well for head coach Kyle Reese in the future, more so than some of these other more veteran teams we're seeing here at the top of Centennial football.
Kamari Brown, the 6'3", 225-pound tight end, the senior who has an NAIA offer, picks up the first down as Overland crosses the midfield stripe on their first possession. A first and 10 at the CT 49-yard line. And they'll go fly sweep with CeCe, and he'll be dropped in the backfield. Kyle Williams combines for the tackle for loss.
Yeah, Williams read that well. I think they struggled, Kai, Yilela, and CeCe struggled to get the ball out of their hands on the snap, a little bit of a bobble. You know, that's another running or a receiver who's going to get involved from the backfield and really just throw as many different looks as they can at this Cherokee Trail defense.
So Kyle Williams and Evan Harrell, a couple of defensive backs for CT, combined for the tackle for loss. So from the CT 49 back to the Overland 49, and they'll try that fly sweep again with CeCe, a penalty marker down, no gain on the run. Kyle Reese, first year head coach of the Overland Trailblazers, talking about the tough transition with the indecisiveness of whether or not there was going to be a season here this fall, and how tough it was to kind of try and implement his system with the lack of spring ball and not a whole lot of practice time before the start of the season. But his years of experience with winning programs like Valor Christian and Cherry Creek the last couple of years, he thinks that experience, bringing that to Overland, is really going to pay off in due time.
Well, he has all the right pedigree and talent. You know, from a coaching aspect, he's seen so much good football be played at other schools in the area. It's just an unfortunate time to take over when you need to, you know, change so much at a new program and you don't have the practices to be able to implement that.
Second and 22. CT dials up the blitz. They dump it off to Brown, and he'll be dropped in the backfield. So the CT defense making some plays. Kyle Williams, the senior, second on the team in tackles coming in, drops Kamari Brown for a loss. And that will bring up a third and very long for the Overland Trailblazers. Almost halfway through this opening quarter tonight in Greenwood Village at the Stutler Bowl. Last season when these two teams met, pretty good ball game. CT won by a final of 30-20. A wide 2x2 set on a third and long. Yilela rolls out, dumps it off over the middle. Catch made, and maybe more. Diving near a first down. Jameel Humphrey made the catch, and he's right near a first down for Overland. Brought down at the 38-yard line of Cherokee Trail. And Humphrey, who plays both ways, making some big plays on offense on the Trailblazers' first possession.
Yeah, he broke that tackle, just spun out of it, and turned it upfield for another 5 or 10 to get the first down. There was a flag on the play, and looks like it's going to be coming back. The referees and even the sidelines looked like they were content to move forward, and it's going to be coming back now. Late holding call.
So the Trailblazers, who quickly moved across the midfield marker on their first possession, they have been plagued by a couple of holding penalties. And they will try third and long. Third and long becomes third and really, really long. All the way back to the 19-yard line. Remember, they started this drive on the 20.
Yeah, and they broke across half, midway pretty early on into their possession. And to be, back behind the 20 is just not really a good look for, an Overland team that struggles on offense and, got something together early.
Not too often you hear third and 42, but that's what it is for Overland. They need the CT-39 for a fresh set of downs. Cougars bring four, and that's over the head of Humphrey. Keyshawn Burns, the senior linebacker in coverage, and Overland will punt. Let's talk about the CT defense. They gave up a combined 101 points in the first two games, their first 0-2 start in 11 years. In the three games since, all victories, this is a defense that's allowed less than 20 points per game.
Yeah, complete turnaround to 180. And you can't talk about this Cherokee Trail defense without talking about Hunter Wilson, the captain of this defense. I mean, he leads the team with 36 tackles. He's a big 6-foot linebacker, and he just kind of anchors that defense and sets the tone back there.
Well, the kicking game has been an adventure for Overland this year. Kamari Brown, the team's star tight end, sends that one to the 46-yard line, and so the Cougars on their second possession will start with a short field. Nothing here at the Stutler Bowl in Greenwood Village. Glad you're with us on Cherry Creek TV. Chris Sylvester, JP Hiraoka, our entire crew happy to bring you Friday Night Lights. A lot of cancellations across high school and college football here this weekend, and we are happy to be playing.
Yeah, just fortunate to be able to watch and call a great high school football game and, finish up a great season here in Colorado.
Levine takes that up the middle and won't have much. Malachi Sims, the senior defensive end, stops him after a one-yard run. Kyle Reese thinks he's got a few seniors that can play at the next level, and one of them is Malachi Sims.
Yeah, he mentioned him early today. Doesn't have an offer yet, but if any college is doing any scouting on this video stream, look for Malachi Sims to make big plays. He's done it all year for this Overland defense. It's a team that struggles to get off the field, so he's kind of the star on that defensive front for Overland.
Nate Gay surges down to the 40-yard line. It'll set up CT with a third and four. Cougars were 1-for-2 on third down on their first possession. Although if they stay here and get closer, it could be four down territory.
Sure, it's one of the challenges of that long field position that the Overland put themselves in. They played good defense here to force a third, but
Levine rolls out. Throws on the run, and it's intercepted. Jaheim Roper, the senior, picks off Jaden Levine. And for an Overland defense trying to bounce back after giving up 49 points a week ago, they've got to stop, and they've forced a turnover on CT's first two possessions.
Yeah, Jaheim Roper getting involved early, and that's another one of those players that head coach Kyle Reese mentioned earlier today, someone who might be able to play, at the next level collegiately. And, he mostly gets it done for them on the offensive end, as a running back, but there he picks off Jaden Levine, and just like that, they're going to turn what seemed to be a very sketchy field position into a drive starting at the 30-yard line.
So Roper, who had an interception in the rivalry game against Smoky Hill last week, has now picked off passes in two straight games. Empty backfield, and the throw over the middle is incomplete. Michael Hemingway, the junior defensive back, delivering the hit on Ishmael Cici as he tried to catch that football.
Yeah, the ball was tossed a little bit high, so Cici kind of elevated himself and had to attempt to make the play in the air a little bit. Added to the degree of difficulty there.
Mentioned Kai Ilela, the senior signal caller for Overland, 18 of 42, did throw six touchdowns last week here at Stutler Bowl against Smoky Hill. Inside handoff to Ali Fisher, and he's met and dropped in the backfield. Blake Weir, the senior defensive end, 6'4", 245 pounds, came in and dropped the tailback for a loss of one.
Yeah, nice defensive stand there from Cherokee Trail. And this is one of the things that Overland wants to avoid is any of these third and long situations, anything that gets them, you know, into a position where they have to throw the ball and it becomes very one-dimensional and obvious to read if you're Cherokee Trail.
Empty backfield on third and 11, and that is over the head of CeCe. So they've targeted him a few times on their first two possessions. Ilela has yet to complete a pass to the sophomore wideout, and after the interception, Trailblazers go three and out.
Yeah, we were wondering if that interception might breathe a little bit of life to Overland and get their offense kind of the spark they needed. Getting back on the field early, you know, they're warmed up now. It's a chilly 40-degree night here in Greenwood, Colorado, but they go three and out here and going to be punting from the 20.
Kamari Brown, it's a little more air under this one. And that will roll inside the 35 down to the 33. So we'll get our third look at the Cherokee Trail offense. They'll set up shop in their own territory for possession number three. Glad you're with us. A little more than 3 minutes left to play in this opening quarter. Beautiful day in Greenwood Village leading up to kickoff. Temperatures in the low 50s as we got going. It should be some nice weather early next week. A lot of sunshine.
Yeah,
after and we'll absolutely take that in November.
After a little bit of snow we had here earlier in the week, the sun kind of peeked through and gave us a nice Friday night action.
Inside handoff and only a couple of yards there. Now the Cherokee Trail Cougars had a 21-7 lead last week over Grandview. Wound up winning the game 28-23. An offense that averaged 327 yards per game a season ago. Finished 8-4. Lost to Fairview out of Boulder in the second round of the postseason. Second and eight. Nate Gay explodes through the middle. One man to beat, and Nate Gay has a Cherokee Trail touchdown. Touchdown. 65-yard touchdown run for the junior. Cougars on the board first.
Nate Gay just exploding here in the second half of the season. I mean, he had two touchdowns last week, ran all over Grandview, and helped secure that win for them. And here it is early into the first half here. Gets another one on the board. And Cherokee Trail going to be going up 7-0.
So Gay, who punched in a couple of scores in the win over the Wolves of Grandview last week, opens up the scoring tonight with a 65-yard touchdown run, and that's not going anywhere. Nate Burke, the holder on what appeared to be a designed point after try fake, that does not work, and it remains a 6-0 ball game with a little more than 2 minutes left to play in this opening quarter, but Nate Gay, one of the better tailbacks in the Centennial League this year, just a junior, so he'll be back again in 2021, and you see his explosive speed as he gets to the second, third level.
Absolutely, completely on display there, and he did run for 750 yards or so last year in 2019, so we've seen the talent in the past, just a little bit of a pedestrian start, like I said, to this 2020 season, but the talent level just fully on display tonight and in previous weeks.
So the Cougars strike first. Cherokee Trail under the direction of fourth-year head coach Joe Johnson, longtime head coach at Thunder Ridge, where he spent 17 seasons and captured three state championships. Trying to bring that championship pedigree to CT. Short kick, Kamari Brown on the return. And the senior rumbles ahead to the 40-yard line, so some decent field position for an Overland offense that would like to get going. They've had the football a couple of times. First time they crossed the midfield stripe, couple of penalties backed them way up. Last time they went three and out, and we'll see what Kai Ilela and company do on possession number three.
Just got to get out of their own way. They've moved the ball all right. They did, especially earlier in their first possession. Kind of broke down with some penalties, you know, a miscommunication on a snap, and a loss for of 10 or so on the backfield. So they can eliminate those types of plays, play mistake-free football. I think it's going to be a very competitive matchup.
Ilela under center. And an inside handoff. That's Roper. And Jaheim Roper gets loose inside the 40. And he's driven down by Jack Love at the 37-yard line. So Roper, who had the interception earlier, only one carry last week, but rips off a big run to get Overland right back into CT territory.
He has fingerprints all over the game already. Looking to not only getting them going on defense, but then punch one in. He was nearly free in the end zone there.
23-yard run for the 6'1", 175-pound senior. Roper the feature back again, and he'll try to get around the left end, and he stumbles down to about the 36-yard line. A lot of athletes trying to find their place in Kyle Reese's system, and Roper certainly one of the better defensive backs in the Centennial League this year, but saw it on that run a couple of plays ago. He's an explosive player on offense if he finds a crease.
Certainly, this Overland team isn't devoid of athletic talent. It's just the shortened season and the fact that Kyle Reese is a first-year head coach. Didn't really have the reps and the practices with COVID to kind of see who those athletes are and you know exactly where they should line up. So they're in a lot of bunched up positions. You know, it's hard. You can only really run one player. So it's this sort of running back by committee with a lot of their athletes.
Mason Maddox, the senior defensive end, who also plays on the offensive line. He's a big kid, 6'3", 265 pounds. Brought down the tailback. Christopher Lindsay there, usually wears 25, wearing 33 this week. Lindsay led the team with 74 yards on 10 carries in the loss here to Smoky Hill last week. So it's 3rd and 8 for Overland. Ilela throws on the run, and it's knocked away. Looking for CeCe, and Love in coverage knocked it away. Decision time for Kyle Reese with a 4th and 8 down at the 36-yard line of Cherokee Trail. Looks like the offense will stay out there.
I like that decision from first-year coach Kyle Reese. Stay aggressive. You know, you just got scored on. They didn't score the extra point, so you're not down a full touchdown, but you want to kind of match them here. 26 seconds left in the quarter. Would love to get out with a score here.
Empty backfield, 5 wide receivers. Overland needs the 27 for a fresh set of downs, and it's a pooch punt from the quarterback. He's done that from time to time this year, and that's saved from, no, they almost saved it. They tried to.
Saved and then lost.
Nearly a beauty, but CT will get a fresh set of downs and the ball back inside of 30 seconds, up 6-0. We'll start at the 20-yard line. Glad to have you with us. Final regular season Friday night in Colorado high school football. Chris Sylvester, JP Hiraoka on hand. Called the Major League Baseball season the 60-game sprint. Here in Colorado, we've had the 6-game high school football sprint.
Yeah, we're not totally done here. The regular season going to be winding down tonight, but this Cherokee Trail team definitely has playoff intentions and hopes after getting, hopefully getting a victory tonight. And as well, this Overland team going to be moving on the road to play Doherty next Friday.
And Nate Gay bulldozing forward. A lot of yards after contact and dropped at the 28-yard line. Had the 65-yard touchdown run to open up the scoring on CT's last possession, and that will be the final play of the opening quarter. So we're off to quarter number 2 on a Friday night in Greenwood Village, Colorado. And the 9th-ranked Cherokee Trail Cougars have a 6-0 lead over the Trailblazers of Overland.
First time.
Yeah, Quarter number two at the Stutler Bowl. The ninth-ranked Cougars of Cherokee Trail with a 6-0 lead. In the road white jerseys, Nate Gay stretching left. And he picks up a first down to the 30-yard line. Gay, 5'10", 180 pounds. Averaged close to 6 yards per carry at a very promising sophomore season, and he's been able to put it all together here in his junior campaign.
Clearly, that's what we're seeing here from him early on into this one, and they seem to be giving the ball to him at will. Maybe not super thrilled with how Jaden Levine was, you know, throwing that ball in the first quarter, but that's another run right up the middle with Nate Gay.
This time, not much running room against the inside of Overland's defense. No gain on the run for Nate Gay. Now the Trailblazers, while they felt they took a big leap forward on offense last week, there's a big emphasis on playing some better defense tonight. And outside of that 65-yard touchdown run that Gay had on CT's last possession, I think Kyle Reese ought to be happy with what he's seen out of this unit thus far.
Yeah, they're just going to need to clean up sort of the big plays. That's what's going to hurt them. And this is a team in Cherokee Trail that certainly has the weapons to hurt you in big plays with their size, athleticism, and some of their playmakers that they have.
Certainly, CT trying to find its identity on offense without their star senior tight end, Sam Hart, who is not dressed up tonight. He's here on the sideline.
Yeah, he stayed engaged. He seems to be sort of yelling at his guys, making sure that they're all on the same page when you have someone as talented as him and going to be playing at the next level at Ohio State. So clearly a leader on this team, and it's good to see that even in the face of injury, that doesn't change.
CT 1-for-2 on third down. Levine wings it over the middle. Catch made. Nate Burke motors across the 45, and down he goes at the 48-yard line. So an 18-yard catch and run, senior to senior. Levine hits Burke, and a fresh set of downs for the Cougars.
Nate Burke, a sizable 6'3", 185 receiver. He kind of threw that up high, and Nate Burke was the only one that could sort of reach it up there.
Six catches, 47 yards, a touchdown for Burke last week. Levine on play action, dumps it off, and that's dropped by Pierce. Now Pierce has had a big junior year. Seven catches, 50 yards last week. Hasn't hauled one in tonight, but he kind of caught everybody's attention early in the season in that wild opener. It was a 62-50 loss for CT to Eagle Crest, but he had a 94-yard touchdown run on a fly sweep play. And talking to Dave Logan, the legendary head coach who's at Cherry Creek now, he said he's not sure if he's ever seen a high school kid here in the state of Colorado make a play like that 94 yards out.
Yeah, such a long play. And Jack Pierce also got it done last week and scored the opening touchdown for this Cherokee Trail team to get the scoring going against Grandview. And then it was Nate Gay who scored a pair of touchdowns to give him that 21-7 lead early on in that one. And then it sort of fizzled out in the second as Cherokee Trail really failed to score. And that's something Overland's got to look at and look to do tonight is how can you halt such a talented Cherokee Trail offense that's been putting up big numbers against teams like Eagle Crest?
Kyle Reese takes a timeout as his defense gets ready to try and stop CT on a 3rd-and-2. That last play went to Pierce, his first catch of the night. 8-yard gain, and while Levine and some other key guys will graduate after the season, I think Joe Johnson, in his 4th season at the helm of this Cougars program, has to be happy with the juniors that he's projected to have coming back next year.
Absolutely. I mean, Joe Johnson's got to be happy with his entire team's performance thus far in the Centennial League in 2020. We're looking at the 8th-ranked team in Colorado here in Cherokee Trail, and actually 3 teams out of the Centennial League in the top 10 in Colorado, with Cherokee Trail, Cherry Creek at the number 1 spot, and then just a couple spots below, number 5, Eagle Crest. So yeah, we're looking at an incredibly stacked and talented division here.
Well, out of the Kyle Reese timeout, he's got 2 left in this opening half. It's 3rd-and-2 for CT. Gay, the feature back. Levine tried to draw Overland offsides on the hard count. Four receivers in the formation for CT, and it's Gay. Stretching left, got a first down, and he's hit and dropped shy of the 40-yard line. Well, with Kyron Hyslop, the number two tailback, sideline now for a few weeks. Gay has been asked to do a bit more in this offense, and in a lot of ways, Cherokee Trail has benefited from that.
Yeah, as his role has expanded, so has this Cherokee Trail offense gotten a little more versatile, a little more explosive with the junior back there.
Overland dials up the blitz, Pierce is wide open, stays on his feet, touchdown, Cherokee Trail.
Yeah, we just mentioned him, Jack Pierce, just an explosive player who continues to make big plays. We mentioned the 94-yard jet sweep to open up the season for them, and just an incredible turn and score right there for the young receiver.
So Levine throws his ninth touchdown here in his senior campaign, number 30 in his varsity high school career. And it's 12-0 CT inside of 10 minutes left to play. And another offense will try the two-point conversion to go up 14-0.
See if they can make up for their woes earlier.
Levine fires a slant, and that's incomplete. So the two-point conversion fails, and the CT lead is 12-0. Well, Jack Pierce mentioned it earlier. He has been a guy that has had a breakout junior season. Only had a couple of catches, couple of carries last year as a sophomore, but 7 catches, 50 yards last week, couple of catches on that last possession, including the big touchdown catch and run.
Yeah, Jack Pierce continues to impress. I mean, the footwork and the fundamentals there. I mean, he had his man beat, so more or less just an open catch. But to turn around, make that grab, and then finish into the end zone, very impressive footwork, and to stay in bounds is what you like to see if you're a wide receiver coach.
Noah Fishback, a senior, handles the kicking duties for CT, and he's got it on the tee at the 40-yard line. Short kick will come on a hop to CeCe. He's a playmaker. He hits the edge and spins across the 45-yard line. So the short kick and the good kick return from the sophomore will set up Overland on their first possession of the second quarter. They'll start this one 53 yards shy of the goal line, and they'll try and generate some more offense on this possession.
Well, if you're Overland, you haven't been without opportunities. You got the pick early on in the game on Jaden Levine, setting you up for good field position. You broke into the opponent's half earlier on your first possession, and here you are starting your drive at the 45. And then a bobbled snap. They just can't get out of their own way, it seems.
Well, that hopped right back into the arms of Ilayla, who scampers out of bounds right near the original line of scrimmage. Kai Ilayla, see what he could do in an encore this evening. 6 touchdown throws with the senior captain last week. Also has played basketball and participated in track and field at Overland.
That's all you need to know to see that he's quite an athlete. I mean, track and field star, a basketball player, and here he is in his final regular season game for Overland.
He drops the throw on second down, and Kamari Brown can't hold on. Brown, the senior tight end, 6'3", 225 pounds, 4 catches, 63 yards. A couple of touchdowns last week. He holds an offer from Culver Stockton College, an NAIA program in Canton, Missouri. Home of the Wildcats out of the Heart of America Conference. Head coach Kyle Reese absolutely sees him as a next level player. So it's 3rd and 10 for Overland. Play clock is winding down, and they'll take a timeout. So Overland with 1 timeout left. They trail 12-0 here in the opening half of football. And their offense will have a 3rd and 10 from the 47.
Yeah, Kyle Reese just wants to make sure he draws up the right play here. Down 12-0, I think he sees himself and his team, you know, within striking distance and very much within this game. And before it gets sort of out of hand, wants to make sure that he's giving himself and his team the best opportunity to win.
Well, there you see Sam Hart, the 6'5", 225-pound senior tight end in street clothes tonight. The three-star prospect headed to play for the Ohio State Buckeyes. Picked Ohio State, had 21 FBS offers, and, well, not a bad choice.
Yeah, interesting to see him there, given a little chat to Nate Burke, who it looks like has been sort of lining up in that tight end position. He's, you know, a big 6'3", 6'4", receiver, so he's got the size to do it, but usually sort of lines up as a receiver next to, you know, the 6'5", Sam Hart, the future Ohio State player. But with him on the sideline, going to be picking up those duties and just passing along a little bit of information.
Overland needs the 43 of CT for a fresh set of downs. Cougars bring four, and that's incomplete. Siam Tekel, the junior who had a catch last week, targeted for the first time tonight. And, well, this CT secondary has made it awfully tough for Ilayla to find his receivers.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you wonder, we talked to Kyle Reese earlier in the day, and he emphasized how their run game has changed their offense since they've been going more to it. And with what Cherokee Trail has been giving them, the looks defensively, you wonder how soon they'll go back to something like that, and getting those guys like Jaheim Roper, Jameel Humphrey, you know, Christopher Lindsay, and, you know, Khalil Ali Fisher, guys like that involved.
Kamari Brown sends it away, and Jack Pierce won't have a chance to return it. Out of bounds it goes at the 28-yard line, or 22. One official's at the 28, the other's at the 22. They'll spot it at the 22-yard line. Well, an important sequence on the horizon for this Trailblazer defense. They don't want to get down by too much here in the opening half. They've certainly got the weapons on offense to score, but certainly CT, they've looked a lot better on their last two possessions.
And Overland's defense hasn't played poorly tonight. They've given up a couple big plays that have hurt them, as well as, you know, their own field position has led to some great field position on the other side of the ball for Cherokee Trail. So I think it just comes down to limiting those big plays and you know, punting the ball deeper into the territory so they're not starting at the 40, 50-yard line. Give yourself a chance to make a defensive play.
6-yard run for Nate Gay to start this possession. CT punted, and they turned over the football on their first two possessions, but a different story their last two. An 8-Gay 65-yard touchdown run and a Jack Pierce touchdown reception as Gay gets tripped up after a short run here, and it will bring up third down for Cherokee Trail. Well, the Cougars seeking their first four-game winning streak since the start of the 2018 season when they started 6-0. You look at some of the data coming into this final regular season weekend. If they win tonight, they will be in the postseason.
Yeah, a shortened season lends to an abbreviated or smaller roster that makes the playoffs. So a team like Overland, you know, generally would be moving forward into the playoffs, even undefeated.
Well, there's Pierce on third down, another catch for the junior. And he's out to the 37-yard line to pick up a fresh set of downs for CT. Cougars now 3-for-4 on third down tonight. Yeah, but you mentioned it last year. Overland did not win a Centennial League game. They finished 3-8 and did make it into the postseason,
yeah,
where they lost to their rivals, Smoky Hill.
You compare that to this year when we're looking at an eighth-ranked, you know, Colorado Cherokee Trail team that's not even secured for the playoffs already. Just a wild difference between 2019 and 2020.
Levine pumps, now he throws, and the catch made out across the 40-yard line.
Looks like the ball came out there, but I think just went out of bounds, so Overland going to maintain possession.
First catch for Noah Greer, who led the team with four catches and 86 yards last week. It was a big win for CT over Grandview. Wolves usually one of the better programs around here.
Grandview's played everyone in the Centennial League incredibly tough. It's difficult, obviously, if you're a Grandview fan to lose as many close games as that.
Yeah.
But, I mean, they're the 13th ranked team in Colorado, so that really, you know, edged back into the top 10 between this Cherokee Trail team and Grandview.
Alex Sturbis, who had a couple of catches last week, couldn't hold on there, and it'll bring up another third down for Cherokee Trail.
Like you said, Cherokee Trail has been incredible, I mean, honestly, at converting this year. even last week against Grandview. Their first score took 8 minutes off the clock to go from one end to the other and just converted on every third down. So we'll see if that continues tonight.
Now Levine fires a bullet over the middle and the catch made just shy of a first down. Nate Burke hauls it in. Fourth and one for CT at their own 46-yard line. And Joe Johnson not hesitating at all to keep his offense on the field.
No, and that's what you like to see if you're a Cherokee Trail fan. The offense actually called their own number and said, hey, coach, let's stay out here. Everyone looked back at the coach and said, we want to stay out. We're going for this.
And I think Overland hopped off sides. Well, the hard count got Malachi Sims.
One of the more talented players on this Overland defense. So impressive nonetheless from Jaden Levine, who's looked a couple times tonight to hard count the defense.
12-0, CT on top. The Cougars winners of three in a row after starting the season 0-2 against a couple of teams that'll duke it out for the Centennial League title tomorrow, Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek. Nate Gay plowing forward, gets inside the 45. A 5-yard run for the junior tailback. First meeting between these two programs came back in 2008. And Overland have already dug themselves a two-possession hole in this game. They're seeking their first win over the Cougars since 2014. That was the Trailblazers' last winning season. They did finish at 500, posted a 5-5 record back in 2017. Second and six. Pierce on the screen with a penalty marker down. Motors inside the 35-yard line, but this is in the area of holding and probably coming back.
Yeah, the referee is going to be taking a long discussion here. I think it was a hold on Cherokee Trail, so going to be moving backwards. In fact, that is the call.
First penalty against CT in this opening half, and a rather costly one. Instead of a fresh set of downs, they'll back up into their own territory. Second and 14. Jaden Levine, the senior, at the controls of this Cougar offense, his final regular season game. Wide 2x2 set, Gay the feature back, and he'll dive forward to the 49-yard line. Ronnie Teckelmichael, the junior, made the stop for Overland.
Quickly back to third and 12 here for Cherokee Trail. Kind of stalled out on this possession. Their a lot of their conversions have come off of penalties or drawing players off of sides. So you want to see Cherokee Trail actually gain yardage on their own volition here.
CT 3 of 5 on third down. Levine rolls out, throws on the run, catch made. Burke down to the 35-yard line. So they pick up 16 yards on third and long, and the Cougars have a fresh set of downs.
Nate Burke looks to be playing a little more inside down the middle, or over the middle, excuse me, kind of taking that tight end role that we were discussing, that Sam Hart role, usually kind of lines more up towards outside the numbers and uses that size to kind of post up.
Approaching the 5-minute mark here in the second quarter. Levine dumps it off. That's Pierce. Hits the edge. Jack Pierce down the sideline. Touchdown, Cherokee Trail. Second touchdown throw from Jaden Levine to the junior Jack Pierce.
Yeah, Jack Pierce just continues to impress. He's just such a good runner in open space. They keep giving him these little screen passes and dumps because they just want to get him the ball anywhere on the field because they believe he'll sort of make people miss. Doesn't matter if they're getting it to him at the line of scrimmage or just a couple yards past, he's going to gain a lot.
So Levine, who threw for 302 yards, 2 touchdowns on his birthday last week against Grandview, is having a nice belated celebration tonight as the point after try woes continue for CT, That was Burke attempting the kick.
Looked a little awkward there, the big 6'3", 6'4", receiver. Not usually a place kicker, but that one gets blocked. So it's going to be three touchdowns, no extra points converted here. 4:58 remaining in the second quarter, so three score difference here, but Overland still very much alive.
Nothing our score. A trio of touchdowns in the opening half. There's Fishback. The short kick will be taken by Khalil Ali Fisher. He'll take a few CT Cougars with him to the 36-yard line. So inside of 5 minutes, it's a three-possession lead for the Cougars of Cherokee Trail in the opening half. And this Overland offense will try and put it together here. The 39 points they scored last week were the most in a single game from an Overland offense since putting up 47 October of 2017 against Arapaho.
Yeah, just ridiculous. I mean, they combined for 29 points through the first four games, so that really, you know, showcases their scoring woes and how impressive it was last week to put up 39 against a Smoky Hill team that's been competitive.
Ollie Fisher gets 4 yards on this carry. Was the old wagon wheel game here at the Stutler Bowl last Thursday night. Always one of the better rivalry games around these parts. Screen pass is caught. A first down and more.
Pass from Kyler is complete to number three, Jameel Humphrey.
Jameel Humphrey. His first catch, and he takes it down to the CT 44-yard line.
Jameel Humphrey looking spry. Made a couple defenders miss there to pick up the first down and more. And just like that, Overland into Cherokee Trail territory. Let's see what they can do with it.
That's complete to CeCe. And even though these are some easy passes for Kai Ilela, you hope that it gets him and this Overland offense going.
Well, he strung together, you know, a couple nice offensive plays in a row. And just like that, they're driving. You know, they started about the 30, and here they are about the 38 of Cherokee Trail. You just got to see them kind of move through that enemy territory and into that red zone, because that's where they haven't been able to, sort of where their offense has stagnated tonight.
Trailblazers get 6 on CeCe's first catch. Delayed handoff. Ali Fisher will be dropped in the backfield. A loss of 2 back to the 40-yard line, and it'll bring up third down about 6 for Overland.
Yeah, a little show of emotion from the defense of Cherokee Trail. So they're still very much in this game, even leading 18-0. They're still emotionally engaged, and you know, playing that last regular season game of the year, you know, puts a little extra in you.
Third and a long 6. Could be 4 down territory for Overland. Inside of 4 minutes. Second quarter. Whistles blow, and Overland takes a timeout, their last of the opening half. So an important third and about 6 upcoming for Kyle Reese. First-year head coach, spent the last 2 years as the wide receiver coach under Dave Logan at Cherry Creek, also an assistant at Fowler Christian. So, I mean, he's been with a couple of the best programs around here, and he knows what it takes to build a program and get him to a championship level. And he's got a lot of work to do at Overland, but he said he wouldn't have taken the job if he didn't think that this was a program that could eventually get there.
Yeah, Valor Christian and Cherry Creek, you know, the top two teams in the in Colorado respectively, and you can't really ask for more of a different or an opposite head coaching matchup between Kyle Reese, the first year head coach, and Joe Johnson, only his fourth year at Cherokee Trail here, but he's won 3 state championships in Colorado. He spent 17 seasons at Thunder Ridge, just a veteran, lining up against a rookie.
Third down, pressure coming, throw over the middle, and it's incomplete. Ismail CeCe targeted on third down, and he couldn't hold on. Elijah Graham in coverage.
You'd imagine Kyle Reese is going to keep his offense on the field here with 3:21 remaining in the first half. Definitely want to get some points on the board going into halftime and in a part of the field that at the high school level, tough to deal with, tough to kick a field goal in.
On fourth down, two receivers each side. Humphrey motions into the slot. Pressure coming. He throws off his back foot. Catch made, but a takeaway. Hemingway ripped it away at the last moment from Christopher Lindsay. It'll technically be a fumble recovery, but he snatched it right out of the arms of the junior tailback who made the catch.
Yeah, Michael Hemingway and I think it was Evan Harrell there kind of combined and gang tackled him, kind of put him in an awkward position and just dropped the ball like it as he kind of landed on his back. Just like that, when we're looking at Overland potentially moving into the red zone of Cherokee Trail, here we are again with Cherokee Trail starting at the 45-yard line.
First takeaway for this Cougar defense. They have been awfully good the last few weeks, giving up just 19 points per game after giving up 101 in the first two games. So Levine and the offense back to work. He bobbles the snap, and Overland will blow that play up in the backfield, a loss of three. A few different black and green jerseys getting in on the tackle for loss. Damaris Davis, Malachi Sims, and others drop the quarterback for a loss of three.
Good to see there from this Overland defense. They haven't put a ton of pressure on Jaden Levine, but not going to be so comfortable now after feeling that one.
Overland out of timeouts. Joe Johnson and CT, they still have three left. Fly sweep. Here's Pierce. A couple of touchdown catches for the junior tonight. And they'll get 4 yards on that run to the 44-yard line, bringing up third and nine.
Yeah, Jack Pierce, the speedster. Once he gets that, turns that outside corner. Didn't work out for him that time, but you can just see the wheels turning under that kid. Just so much turnover. Not the tallest or biggest player, but so much speed, so much agility, making guys miss. And you can see sort of why Joe Johnson has the trust and the wherewithal to, you know, get in the ball as often as possible.
CT, 4 of 6 on third down. He's going deep. Sturbis makes the catch. Touchdown, Cherokee Trail. Alex Sturbis, a late addition to the roster in 2020, making a big impact in the CT offense the last couple of weeks. And he slipped right behind the defense. Fourth touchdown to the opening half for the Cougars.
Yeah, they're getting him on that outside corner, passing, you know, over the top. And these Overland receivers just, I don't think they respect Jaden Levine's arm strength and the gun he carries back there, because he's making 30, 40-yard passes and moving while doing it. So I think they need to drop back a little bit further and stop trying to undercut these receivers.
Three touchdown throws for Jaden Levine, the star senior quarterback tonight. And Fishback, who for whatever reason wasn't out there the first few times they attempted point after tries, finally knocks one through.
Fourth time's the charm there.
We've got a 25-0 ball game in the opening half inside of 2 minutes. Overland will get the football first when we get into the second half, and we'll see if their offense can put a little something together, but they're out of timeouts and they don't have much time.
No, and for a team that's their best production has come from running the ball in recent weeks at least, you wonder what they're going to be able to put together with a minute 43, you know, no 2 minute warning, no timeouts for them. I still like their timeout calls that they made. It seemed like at 3:30 and, you know, a third down, that's a pivotal moment sometime. You know, you're going to have to call your timeout here, but really like to put up some points on the board with, you know, down 25-0, give you guys some hope for the fourth.
There's Levine, 14 and white for CT. Three touchdown throws tonight and now 32 in his career at the varsity level with Cherokee Trail. And Joe Johnson, as you mentioned, just in his fourth season at the helm of the program. I mean, when you're trying to win games, you need a reliable quarterback that you could start for a couple of years more times than not. And, well, Jaden Levine, I mean, he's been spectacular.
Yeah, I mean, he's been that for Joe Johnson, just kind of been a rock for him. As we see, the ball has been blown over, I think, three or four times now. We wonder when. Here comes the placeholder.
Caden Porter assisting his teammate, Noah Fishback, the senior kicker. 25-0. Four touchdowns in the opening half for CT. Jamil Humphrey on the kick return. Up the right sideline and tackled near the 40-yard line. So the issue hasn't been field position.
No. They've started, I think, every single possession right there between the 30 and 40.
This is an offense that showed you last week they can score in bunches and they can score it quickly, 39 points. It was a streaky 39-point performance. They had 19 points in the second quarter, and they had 20 points in the fourth quarter last week against Smoky Hill.
Yeah, even this Cherokee Trail team was a little bit bursty last week, scoring in bunches. You know, put up 21 in the first half and then only 9 in that second half. Looks like Kai Ilela is going to hold on to the ball this time.
I did a lot of that last week against Smoky Hill. And Ilela picks up a few yards, stops the clock as he scampers out of bounds inside of 90 seconds.
One thing to note on the defensive end there, Jamil Humphrey been lining up defensively as well for head coach Kyle Reese. And after his player got burned for the touchdown, helped him up, gave him a pat on the head, and you know, said, let's get back out there and do this. We're going to be taking offense now. So you just like to see that mentality from a player and hope that he can get the ball here so he can, you know, keep his team in the game.
Jaheim Roper, the lone setback on a 2nd and 7. The blitz is dialed up again. Ilela is sacked. Ellis Williams, the linebacker, came in on the blitz. And Ilela gets dropped back at the 32-yard line. And now CT takes a timeout, perhaps trying to buy some time for their offense if they do see the field again here in the opening half.
Spectators, thank you for attending tonight's contest. Sure, I mean, Cherokee Trail, a team that, I mean, with 60 seconds or even less, you feel like you might have an opportunity to score with some of the big play weapons that they have on this roster. It's funny to see Jack Pierce over here talking with Sam Hart and Nate Burke. He almost looks like their, you know, younger brother or something. He's got 2 touchdowns on the game, so it's not like they don't, you know, respect him or love him as a teammate, you know, helping bring this team towards a victory tonight. But man, is there a size difference there.
Yeah, 11 and 13, Pierce and Sturbis. Pierce a couple of touchdown catches, and Alex Sturbis breaking out late in the season for this CT squad. Also has a touchdown catch. So it's 3rd and 17. And CT jumped off sides.
Hit him with a little bit of their own medicine there. Hard count of the defense. That's something we've seen Jaden Levine do for Cherokee Trail all night long, or at least attempt to do, and you know, brought him off at least once or twice. Kai Ilela hits him with it.
Ilela, the 6 touchdown throws last week. He and this Trailblazer offense, they have been shut out in this opening half tonight, and trying to make some noise late in the second quarter. Three receivers in the formation. Ilela dances out of the pocket, throws on the run, catch made. CeCe spins away at the 40. Ishmael CeCe inside the 30 and dropped at the 29-yard line.
Oh, what a play from Kai Ilela there to extend the time of possession and to extend the play with his feet. Finds his receiver, his talented receiver, Ishmael CeCe, up the field and converts the first down, and they're looking to score here.
Ilela in this offense moving quickly. Kamari Brown can't hold on as the pass sails over his head. Ishmael CeCe, 5 catches, 91 yards, 3 touchdowns last week. That was his second first half catch in this game, and he might be one of the better young receiver prospects in the Centennial League.
Yeah, sure. And that's just so exciting for head coach Kyle Reese to have. I mean, he was a wide receiver coach at Cherry Creek, you know, a team that's definitely has its fair share of talent in that position. And, you know, head coach Dave Logan, a famous receiver in the area and former Broncos and Cleveland Browns receiver. So they know what they're doing there with their wideouts.
Ilela takes off, and
I think a late hit might come in there. They definitely are appealing for it.
Oh, man.
And now Cherokee.
I think maybe that's a play on elsewhere, but he did certainly get shoved a little bit. And
he got touched.
We do protect our quarterbacks, and that'll certainly help out the Trailblazers if, in fact, it is a late hit penalty against CT. It'll move the ball half the distance to the goal.
I think the refs are discussing it. Probably saw the same play.
The two penalty markers flew in, so I think it is a bit of a discussion here, but I think Overland will move into the red zone for the first time tonight, but we'll see. Late hit out of bounds. All right, so that'll move the ball half the distance to the goal. It'll be the first red zone trip for Overland. We did mention that they get the football first to start the third quarter, so this is a team, if they can score here late in the opening half and put some points on the board, they'll have a little bit of momentum as we get ready for half number two.
Certainly, and with the extra point misses and the fact that Cherokee Trail has struggled in the second half in previous games and previous weeks, I mean, if you can get a score here and really turn up the offense in the second half or continue what you've seen here in the last minute, I mean, they've gone almost the length of the field in about 35 seconds, albeit with a couple, you know, some penalty help. But this game is not over by any stretch of the imagination if they can get in here and hold Cherokee Trail in the second half.
Inside of a minute, Trailblazers out of timeouts, but on the move in the red zone for the first time this evening. Empty backfield, five wide receivers for Ilela. He brings Ollie Fisher in motion, fires over the middle, and CeCe was the intended target. The pass incomplete.
Well, CeCe was open there. Ismail, you know, a quick first step, but I think Kai Ilela just threw the ball a little bit too soon and didn't let him get that separation with his man. It's a little bit of a rush there.
Well, they have tried to go to CeCe early and often in this game on that slant, but unable to connect there. Clock stops for a second and 10. The penalty marker's down. Somebody jumped. Offsides. Second time that Kai Ilela has balked and gotten CT to jump offsides. So the penalty yardage has really worked against the Cougars in their defense on this possession. It'll move the ball down to the 10-yard line. Now you got to get in here if you're Overland.
Yeah, absolutely. Not a trip down that you can afford to not score, you know, seven.
Tight formation there for the Trailblazers. Ilela, play breaks down. He wings it on the run. It's bobbled, and Humphrey can't hold on. Hunter Wilson, the team's leading tackler, senior out of CT in coverage, and it's third down.
Yeah, Humphrey almost turned around and made that play on a little bit of a bobble. It's been a little bit quiet tonight, but he did lead the team in receptions last week. He got in the end zone, finished with about 70 yards and a score. So look for him to maybe get something done on this left side of the field.
So now it's third and five. Ollie Fisher, the lone setback. He'll get the call, stretching right. Ollie Fisher has a first down. Tackled at the 3-yard line. First and goal for the Overland Trailblazers.
And in a lot of ways, that works out perfectly because with 39 seconds left on the clock, you don't really want to be handing the ball back to a Cherokee Trail team or even really kick it to them. So this will bleed a little bit more time off the clock, and then you just got to focus on getting in.
Ollie Fisher, ball comes loose. It's on the ground. CT says they have it. And they do.
So maybe not perfect. It's been the story of the night for Overland, is getting pretty close or deep into enemy territory, and then mistakes costing either the football or, you know, the play.
Well, a disheartening end to what was Overland's best possession of the night. And a little miscommunication between Elayla and Ollie Fisher, and ball came loose. CT picks it up, and now it looks like the Cougars will take a knee into halftime. And that'll do it. Opening half in the books here at Stutler Bowl in Greenwood Village, Colorado. The ninth-ranked Cougars at a Cherokee Trail with a convincing 25-0 lead over the Overland Trailblazers at halftime. We'll step aside. You're watching Cherry Creek TV on YouTube.
Thank you.
Well, we welcome you back to the Stutler Bowl in Greenwood Village, Colorado. Final weekend of the high school football regular season in the state of Colorado. Got the postseason starting next week. Overland and Cherokee Trail meeting tonight, and the Cougars, ninth-ranked team, up 25-0 at halftime. Chris Sylvester, J.P. Hiraoka, our entire crew, glad you could be with us on this Friday the 13th.
It's definitely been Friday the 13th for Overland through the first half. Not so much for Cherokee Trail, but there's been a couple bright spots for this Overland team. Mostly Jaheim Roper. I mean, he got a pick early on in the game in the first quarter and then broke open about a 10 or 20-yard play on the ground in the second quarter on the offensive side. But still yet to get into the end zone for Overland.
Well, Overland winless through their first five games, and unless they could pull off a big second comeback here, they would finish this regular season 0-6. But their season is not finished. While they won't be in the postseason this year, teams that don't make the playoffs are given the option of scheduling a seventh and final game. And Kyle Reese told us that he's got the itinerary ready to head to Doherty and play them next week.
Yeah, it's going to be on the road there. Going to be heading up that way to Doherty on the bus. So
it'll be quite the trip for them. It's down near Colorado Springs, about an hour bus ride or so.
Right. So things not stacking up for them to get their first victory tonight, but look forward to them playing Doherty next week and maybe eking out that first W.
All right, so we're just about ready for the start of the second half. This was just a 6-0 game after one quarter, but the CT offense heating up as that second quarter went along. They scored three touchdowns, and Jaden Levine, the senior quarterback, with three touchdown throws, couple to Jack Pierce, the other to Alex Sturbis.
Yeah, it's been a big night for Jack Pierce. Overland also did get as close as they've gotten in that second quarter, so things have heated up for both teams, but Cherokee Trail yet, or is still the only team to convert.
Ishmael Cece on the kick return for the Overland Trailblazers. Bounces off a tackle, now loses his footing, tries to reverse field, and finally dropped right around the 20-yard line.
Yeah, lost about 5 or 10 yards trying to extend the play and get to the outside. So not necessarily the best decision, but you do like to see, you know, the playmakers trying to get their team back into, you know, contention as quickly as possible. Not going to erase a 25-point lead going an inch at a time.
Spotted back at the 15-yard line. Well, the Overland Trailblazers, their best possession was their last of the opening half that ended with a lost fumble inside the 5-yard line. We'll see how this offense responds after the turnover. CT's defense mentioned how good they've been the last few weeks, less than 20 points per game. Toss play to Roper, and he's got some downfield blocks. Jaheim Roper rumbles up the right sideline and escorted out of bounds across the 35.
Great play design on that one. They brought the receivers from left to right in motion and then got some blocks on the outside right edge for Jaheim Roper to get outside and get out along the numbers. Turns it upfield for about 10 or 12.
Actually picked up 22 yards.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot where they started in the 15.
Elayla throwing near side, and Kamari Brown has been quiet tonight.
Hey, he's looked stiff tonight, not moving as agile as we've seen in past, but still one of the most talented players on this roster, and if they can get him involved, might be able to put up some points on the scoreboard.
Well, this Overland offense, they struggled through the first 4 weeks of the season. They combined for just 29 points in their first four games, then turned around and put up 39 last week, but they've been held off the scoreboard tonight. Second and 10, Elayla. As the play breaks down, he'll take off and run out of bounds across the 40-yard line. Gets close to 6 yards on that run, bringing up third down and 4.
Yeah, makes it third and manageable by turning it upfield and cutting into that 10-yard needed, but yeah, it's been tough for Overland. They've definitely found bright spots with some of their running backs and, you know, scoring more points. They put up 39, like you said, last week. But just tough to get any kind of consistency on the offensive end from them.
Ilela comes out of the pistol on third and four. High snap. Quarterback keeps the football, delivers a stiff arm, and dives into CT territory. Dropped right near the midfield stripe. And a fresh set of downs for Overland. Wait, you saw him on the tape last week, JP, and this was a guy that decided to take off and run a whole lot when plays broke down and there was nothing available downfield. Maybe you would have liked to see that a bit earlier, but making some plays with his legs here to start the second half.
Yeah, he called his own number on that one. I mean, he's a sizable guy, 6'3", 190, moves pretty quickly too. So he's very patient to allow himself to get some room there in his tackles to make blocks.
Well, another option play, and the quarterback, Kai Ilela, steps at about shy of the 45-yard line, so he gets a few there. Ask Kyle Reese, hey, you know, 29 points through your first four games, 39 points last week. What happened? He said, even though we dropped to throw 42 times, we ran the football more effectively than we had all year.
Yeah, even joked about firing the offensive coordinator earlier in the year and then admitted to us that that's himself. So a little self-deprecation from the young head coach, but it's what you like to see. Still having a light fun six games in.
Ilela gets a couple more. Down to the 44-yard line. It'll bring up third and five.
So they seem to have, you know, found a little bright spot in allowing Ilela to have some of these keeps and kind of give them a little more versatility on the offensive end. They've let him hold it the last three possession or plays, rather. So you like to see him kind of keep up the versatility, maybe throw outside to one of those receivers or get one of that big, big backfield that they have involved.
Third and five. This is Christopher Lindsay.
There you go.
And he dives inside the 40 right near a first down. Lindsay was used sparingly in that opening half. Junior, we mentioned earlier, 10 carries, led the team with 74 yards last week. And he picks up first down on third and five there.
Yeah, we haven't seen him since the first quarter when he picked up a first down for this Overland team. But, I mean, he's a big part of this backfield that, you know, runs about four deep back there. But nice pickup there. And that's what these keeps and these options that Kai Ilela has kind of eked out creates, because now they don't know if he's going to hold on to the ball and run himself or if he's going to be making that handoff. Gives a little more deception to that offense.
Ilela, delayed handoff. Lindsay trying to find room around the left end, and he's tripped up inside the 30-yard line right near another trailblazer first down.
Yeah, I think that was kept Lindsay out of the end zone there, as that was a last-ditch effort as he dove for his legs and kind of wrapped him up. Still good for a first down there from Lindsay, but Overland driving here. Some of the best offense we've seen strung together from this Overland team in tonight's game.
10-yard run for the 6-foot junior tailback, Christopher Lindsay. High snap. They'll get it this time on the inside run, and he surges inside the 25 down to the 24-yard line. Another one of those juniors that Kyle Reese is excited to have back for hopefully a full season come 2021.
Yeah, Christopher Lindsay gets a high five on his way out. Going to go get a little breather on the sideline. So see a little bit of a change up in the play calling here as they gave him the ball three times in a row. And that came right after giving Kai Ilela three straight, keeps. So kind of players getting the ball in bunches now. We'll see where they go now.
A little miscommunication. Ilela gets back to the line of scrimmage, but that's all.
Yeah, I don't think he wanted to keep that ball there.
Mason Maddox, the senior defensive end, brought down the quarterback at the line of scrimmage. Blazers 2-for-2 on third down this possession. Jaheim Roper stands behind the quarterback. Bobbled snap, and CT recovers.
Yeah, it's so tough for Overland. Every time they get any kind of continuity or flow going on the offensive end, they seem to turn it over in Cherokee Trail territory. Just come, these mistakes are coming at the worst kind of times for them. And just like that, Cherokee Trail going to take over, 25-0 on the scoreboard.
Kyle Williams, senior defensive back for the Cougars, recovers the fumble. And no question that the last two times this Overland offense has had the football, it's been their best two possessions. They just haven't been able to hold on to the football.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit to like there if you're Kyle Reese and that, you know, you're not struggling to move the ball, say, anymore, but can't get out of their own way and just can't keep the football into that red zone when the tackles seem to get brought up a little more.
Here comes Jaden Levine and Cherokee Trail, their first possession of the second half. And Nate Gay, who had a big 65-yard touchdown run back of the opening quarter, gains a yard and a half up ahead of the 31-yard line. So the Overland offense, they have turned the ball over three times tonight, and you're going up against the top 10 team. It's just simply mistakes you can't afford to make.
No, if they were going to, you know, want to get a W tonight against a very talented Cherokee Trail team, they're going to have to play virtually mistake-free football. And through, you know, a quarter and a half, that's not what we've seen out of Overland.
Penalty marker down prior to the snap.
I think Cherokee Trail moved a little early there. Got ahead of themselves.
Offsides against Overland is the call. Now usually when they blow the play dead, it's on the offense, but
right, a little bit of misdirection gets us confused up here, but
it's all good. I'm not batting too hot on those predictions this year. I'd be like, I think he picked up the first down, and no, he was short by a good yard. Toss play, Nate Gay across the 40, and he's got a first down for the Cougars.
Nate Gay, not the tallest running back out there, 5'10", a stocky dude, but that first tackle that came through did virtually nothing to stop him. He's just a real tank down there. When he gets the ball and he gets a full head of steam going, it's going to take a couple of guys to bring him down usually. Look for the mismatch inside with Nate Burke with a lot of size against his defensive back.
Inside handoff to Gay. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. Run of 7 yards for the junior tailback. Carried it 21 times. Found the end zone twice last week at Legacy Stadium against Grandview. You did have a good career up there. 25-0 our score here at the Stutler Bowl. Final weekend of the regular season. The Centennial League champion will be crowned tomorrow afternoon. Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek, battle of undefeated schools, teaming up. Blitz comes. Levine put a little too much on that one. Nate Burke, the intended receiver. And if he puts that ball where he wanted to, it's probably a touchdown.
Yeah, just as missed his receiver by, you know, a couple feet there. And the receiver got a hand on it, but couldn't haul it in to make the play. Jaden Levine's been pretty accurate tonight, especially going, you know, over the shoulder of his receivers on the outside, kind of out by the numbers. When we were going the other side, left to right for this Cherokee team, he was hitting Jack Pierce on the right side all day long.
Nate Gay cuts and picks up a first down to the 44-yard line. 7-yard run as the Cougars cross the midfield stripe on their first possession of the third quarter. That Eagle Crest-Cherry Creek matchup, something that we've been looking forward to since the start of the season, and on paper, the two best teams in the Centennial League. But Eagle Crest, they've had some COVID issues and had to sit out the last couple of weeks. Weren't sure if they were going to be able to play this weekend, but sure enough, they're ready to go. Test their luck against the defending state champs. Nate Gay was wide open, but Levine put too much on that throw, and it's second and 10.
It was a beautiful play design there. Nate Gay actually started in the backfield, and then Jaden Levine rolled out, got a block, let the ensuing tackles come right at him, and then dropped back to make a 40-yard pass down the right side, just overthrew Nate Gay there. It would have been a touchdown if he had hit him.
Eagle Crest has been led by quarterback that was wearing a Cherokee Trail uniform last season, Khalil Howard, the senior, who's been a big surprise for Eagle Crest. And Sean Marsh. Levine hit as he throws, and that's knocked away. Khalil Ali Fisher, the starting tailback for Overland, also plays some defense for the Trailblazers. He gets credit for the pass breakup, and it's third and 10.
Yeah, Malachi Sims pursuing Jaden Levine there into the backfield. Put a lot of pressure on him, but Jaden Levine, as we can see here in the third quarter, his jersey's pretty clean and has only gone down, I think, for one sack that Overland has earned on the day. If they can dial up the pressure on him, make him feel a little more uncomfortable, they might be able to pick him off like they did earlier in the game.
CT 5 of 7 on third down. Levine wings it to the sideline, and the catch made right near a first down. Noah Greer hauls it in, and it's a fresh set of downs. CT gets it done on third down again against this Overland defense.
Noah Greer led the team in catches last week in Cherokee Trail's victory over Grandview. Hasn't really gotten too involved in tonight's game, but gets the first down and secures Cherokee Trail a good positioning here, driving into Overland territory.
New set of downs for CT. On the move with a first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Little misdirection, and Overland's all over it.
Well read there. That was Damaris Davis. Broke that one up and read the fake handoff all the way. I think they wanted to get Jack Pierce on a little deception going to the outside, and then gave the ball running back on through the inside, and Damaris just blew it right up in the backfield.
That is the second tackle for loss for the junior defensive tackle Damaris Davis tonight. And that a loss of 3 yards to back the football up to the 36.
This Cherokee Trail team plays with a lot of patience. No hurry really in their bones.
Jack Pierce lost the football, and luckily for him, it rolls out of bounds. Just past the first down line. You just dump it off to Jack Pierce and kind of let him do his thing, huh?
Yeah, it just turns into a foot race, and doesn't seem like there's anyone on the field or anyone maybe in this whole stadium that could keep up with the kid. Just set of wheels on him.
Well, spotted at the 21-yard line. And CT, they have strung together a long drive that has milked a lot of time off of this third quarter clock.
It's something that they've been good at this year is putting together these long drives, converting on third down, and controlling time of possession.
And for them to compete with the likes of Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek, they're going to have to own that time of possession. There's no question. They got into a shootout with Eagle Crest in the season opener and lost 62-50. That's not the way Joe Johnson wants his team to try and win ball games. And I think after that 0-2 start, they kind of reinvented themselves and their plan here for 2020. And it's been better defense, maybe not scoring as many points as the 50 points they had in the opening week, but this has been a steady offense that has avoided turning over the football as they did early and often those first 2 weeks. And they're one of the hotter teams around here heading into the postseason next week.
Yeah, I mean, certainly. They put together a nice winning streak, and it looks tonight like it'll continue. But again, I want to touch on those first 2 weeks were against Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek, so the best two teams in this conference. No small task for Cherokee Trail to get wins over them. And part of the reason probably they struggled with, you know, the tackling and the turnovers is playing against the best talent in the division.
This offense a touchdown away from matching what they average through five games, 31 points per game. They led 25-0 at halftime. This is their first possession of the third quarter, and they have marched down to the 21-yard line of Overland. CT has dominated this all-time series. This is the 13th meeting between these two programs. Five in a row, won by the Cougars, and they hold the all-time edge 10-2. Levine hands off Pierce, looking for running room on the outside, and gets down to the 19-yard line. Two-yard run for the junior, who they certainly like to use on those fly sweep plays. Ronnie Teckelmichael, the junior defensive back, brought him down.
Yeah, Ronnie did a great job keeping up with speed, but most of the deceleration, Jack Pierce blitzed to the outside and then put the brakes full on, and Tekelmichael tracked him the whole way and brought him down.
Levine rolls out, surveys the defense, throws on the run, and it's nearly intercepted. Valden Thomas, the junior corner, got a couple of hands on it. Noah Greer was the intended receiver.
Now, even though that play wasn't completed by Jaden Levine, that's something I think we've seen. That's where we've seen the improvement for the senior quarterback, is these throws on the run. We saw it last week against Grandview. We've seen it tonight, you know, a couple touchdown passes. But his ability to move specifically to his left side and get the ball across field 30 yards, hitting players on the move, it's really impressive. A strong
and
guy.
It's almost as if he's more comfortable throwing on the run than in the pocket.
We're starting to see sort of that, because he almost wants to be moving.
And he's moving there, and then he gives it away to Nate Gay. Inside the 10, and Gay's dropped at about the 8-yard line. It'll set up CT with a first and goal. And third down has been very kind to the Cougars tonight. They're now 6 of 8.
Yeah, and Cherokee Trail getting dangerously close to punching in another score here to go up by, you know, more than 30. But if I'm Overland, I want to see them kind of give them a little taste of their own medicine, what Cherokee Trail has done with some of these takeaways in the red zone.
CT on the doorstep. Gay breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage, and then about 4 or 5 black jerseys bring him down for a short gain.
Yeah, number 33, Christopher Lindsay, got in there for the tackle. He's running both ways. We saw him do some real good running from the backfield for this Overland team to get him in the position to, you know, be in the red zone. It's where they made a mistake and turned the ball over as they went away from Lindsay, but makes a nice play on the defensive end, working hard out here.
Four touchdowns tonight for the Cougars. Looking for their first second half score. They'll toss it. Gay is wrapped up. Another short gain. And there's Malachi Sims, the senior defensive end, who brought down Nate Gay by himself. Kyle Reese really high on this kid. Thinks he's a next level guy.
We can see why. He's making plays all over the place, pressuring the quarterback on when he drops back, and also wrapping up a lot of their running backs up the middle. Just a high IQ player that can read the game of football and what's going to be happening in front of him very well and very quickly.
So it's third and goal at the 7-yard line. Four receivers in the formation for CT. They'll bring Pierce in motion. Levine with the pressure coming. He'll take off and slips and falls. He had his eyes on the end zone. His mouth was watering as he saw the open space between he and the goal line, but he slipped and fell right at the line of scrimmage. So now it's fourth and goal. The field goal keeps it at a 4-possession game.
The way they've been kicking tonight and sort of their decision-making around it leads me to believe they're going to keep that offense on the field and go for this.
And it looks like they will. Overland may not have a chance to win this game, but this would be a big win for their defense. Fourth and goal. Levine. Whistles blow. Timeout CT just before the snap. Joe Johnson did not like what he saw from his offense and just got the timeout in. So, yeah, the Cougars have one left inside of 2 minutes left to play, third quarter. 25-0. Cherokee Trail, number 9, leads the Trailblazers of Overland. Chris Sylvester, J.P. Hiraoka on hand, bringing you Centennial League football on Cherry Creek TV on YouTube. We certainly hope you're enjoying the action tonight. We know that the number of spectators at these games this year has been limited, and I'm sure a lot of the fans and family members who haven't had a chance to get out here certainly miss being at these high school football games every Friday night, and we hope we can help make it a little bit easier having to watch from home.
Yeah, we want to be able to provide coverage for the game and let you guys support, you know, your team, your friends, your family, grandsons, grandkids, whatever it may be, however you want to support them. You know, these guys are working hard out here. A lot of them playing both ways. It's chilly low 40-degree night here in Denver as they finish up their regular season here from the Stutler Bowl.
Well, we're supposed to be in the low 40s, but I think we're
staying a little higher.
Yeah, it's a pretty nice night here. 54 degrees in Greenwood Village, according to the weather app, which has failed me before. And CT burns their last timeout. So Joe Johnson had just huddled up his guys for about a minute and then changed his mind or didn't have the right personnel out there.
Yeah, I think Joe Johnson, a game out of, you know, a potential playoff push, I think he wants to make sure, even up 25-0, you know, playing a winless team, he wants his team to be as focused and prepared as they can be and in the best form they can be,
yeah,
moving into a tough playoff schedule. I mean, we've already discussed some of the talent here in Colorado and specifically in the Centennial League, but, you know, mistakes are going to hurt them, and we've seen a number of them from Cherokee Trail. By no means have they played mistake-free football through three quarters, so the veteran head coach wants to see his team kind of iron out some of those wrinkles.
Now, final tune-up before the postseason. If you're going to make mistakes, you want to make them here, but you also kind of want to iron out those mistakes. All right, so I think we're ready for fourth and goal. After a couple of CT timeouts, a wide 2x2 set. Jack Love joins Levine in the backfield. He throws the other way, and it's dropped. Noah Greer could not hold on. And the Overland defense rises to the occasion. They get a fourth down stop inside the 10-yard line. And the Cougars turn it over on downs.
Yeah, head coach Kyle Reese a little bit amped up on the stop there. His players got in the right positions and blew up the pass. Noah Greer just kind of dropped a low one from Jaden Levine there. But a couple Overland players in the vicinity there to make the tackle if he had reeled that one in.
So a long way to go for this Overland offense. See if they can put together their first scoring drive inside of 2 minutes here in the third quarter. An inside run for Ali Fisher out to the 10-yard line. He gains 3 yards. Now running against the inside of this CT defense has been tough for Overland tonight, but when they've been able to get out to the perimeter, that's when they've had some of their bigger plays on offense.
Yeah, Mason Maddox, the big 6'3 offensive lineman, well, he actually plays both ways for this Cherokee Trail front seven. He's been a monster setting the tone up there on both ways, and I think it's just really hard to run anywhere near him.
I'll give it to Ali Fisher again. And he bursts through the middle across the 20. Jack Love stops him at the 23-yard line. 13-yard run. First down for the junior tailback, Ali Fisher.
So we were wondering where if we might see some Jack Love tonight, because he is their backup quarterback. And in such a, you know, route as the 25-0 going into the fourth here, wondered if the junior might get some snaps to, you know, sort of set the tone for the future of this Cherokee Trail team. But mostly we're seeing him here on the defensive end as he makes two tackles in a row.
Another bobbled snap, and Ilela scampers out of bounds after a short gain. He's had some trouble catching those snaps tonight cleanly. 2 yard run for the quarterback.
See what the Overland coaching staff draws up here on a second and nine here. Talked about kind of just getting more simple with their play calling. They thought that sort of the lack of points was coming from overcomplicating their offensive schemes with, you know, a new roster.
A catch for Jameel Humphrey, and he's got a first down for Overland. Taken out of bounds by Evan Harrell at the 36-yard line, and there's an injured lineman down for Overland. That's Chris Sarcody, the senior tackle, and never like to speculate on injuries, but hopefully just a cramp here for the senior playing in one of his final high school games. Mentioned that Overland, they will be left out of the postseason this year, but teams that don't go to the playoffs in this unique shortened 2020 season have the option to schedule a seventh game. And Kyle Reese saw that as an opportunity to get that much better. His team will head down to Doherty next week.
Well, I think it's important for them just to get more reps. And that's, you know, one of the biggest challenges they've had. Like we said, you know, he's a, you know, first-year head coach here at Overland and didn't really get a full season to implement any of his system or any of the things he was trying to do. You know, summer practices and a lot of the camps that we usually see teams in this league go to, the tackling camps and such, all of that was canceled and not a lot of in-person or full team practices. So just so hard to get off the ground if you don't have sort of a bedrock to go back to. And teams like Cherry Creek, you know, former state champions or defending state champions, they have that. And this Overland team started at zero on the season.
So Sarcody helped off the field, able to walk off on his own power. Fresh set of downs for Overland. Final seconds of the third quarter. And Elayla rips off a 13-yard run and shakes out about to the 47-yard line.
Yeah, nice run from the quarterback. He's in the second half clearly kept the ball a lot more and probably leads his team in yardage from scrimmage.
So a 13-yard run for Elayla, who has done a nice job improvising on a lot of plays that haven't been available downfield in this third quarter. Humphrey on the fly sweep, hits the edge, crosses the midfield stripe, and out of bounds he goes, spotted at the 48-yard line. Now you can do so many things with the junior Jameel Humphrey, who plays on defense as well. Six catches, 69 yards, touchdown for Overland last week, and he's a guy that can give you some positive yardage on those fly sweep runs as well.
Yeah, sure, a little bit like Jack Pierce. He's got a lot of speed, probably the smallest player on the field right now, but, you know, he plays with a lot of intensity and a lot of speed and talent, so.
Tight pocket. Elayla takes off again, delivers a stiff arm, and out of bounds he goes right near another first down. He'll have it to the 41-yard line of Cherokee Trail with a penalty marker down back near the line of scrimmage. Remember, quarters cannot end on penalties, so we might have an untimed down here.
Yeah, it looks like we will. And just a quick update on the big tackle, Chris Sarcody, who got injured just a couple of plays back, has just returned to the field, so looks like he's all right. Just a little cramp, got stretched out on the sideline by the athletic trainer. Does look like he has some kind of wrap on his left wrist. Not sure what kind of injury he's dealing with there, but the previous injury was a lower extremity. I think it was some kind of a leg cramp. Both coaches going to draw it up here, make sure they get the right kind of play call.
Well, I guess we can end a quarter on a penalty. Is that new? Is it a high school thing?
Is it a Colorado thing?
I don't know. Can't end it on a defensive penalty.
Ah.
We think. So the third quarter has officially come to an end. And it's still 25-0, same score we had coming out of halftime. And we've got 12 more minutes of football at the Stutler Bowl. Final Friday night lights of the regular season. It was announced earlier this week that the state championship is usually held at the home of the Denver Broncos and Power Field these days. It's been called many things over the last decade or so. They'll be held down at Colorado State Pueblo this year, December 3rd through the 5th.
Yeah, you got to wonder how these, you know, players feel about it. They love that opportunity to get anything Broncos. It's such a big program around here in the Colorado area, but there's still going to be some really great Colorado State playoffs matchups coming up here in the next week or so.
Second and 18. That penalty ended the third quarter, and so we start the fourth. Overland at the 39-yard line. Ilayla being chased from behind and throws it away. Brown was the closest guy to it. And Mason Maddox nearly delivered a big blindside hit on the quarterback. He's lucky he got that one away.
Yeah, I don't know if Kai had eyes in the back of his head or if maybe the big Mason Maddox was kind of tromping around back there and he heard him, but got rid of the ball just in the nick of time to avoid the large hit from Mason. Overland going to bring the three receivers in motion. We've seen this play call before from them. A couple reverses.
A little double reverse. They'll try and get CeCe out in space. Ishmael CeCe spins back into CT territory, and he's 3 yards shy of a first down. So a little trickery there, and it picks up 15 yards for the Trailblazers. And in a 25-0 game, fourth quarter, in enemy territory, you might keep your offense out there, and it looks like Kyle Reese will.
Yeah, one of the best things that Overland's done in this game as far as, you know, boding for the future is avoided a running clock, and that's going to help a lot of these younger players. We mentioned how they have, you know, 12 sophomores, 5 freshmen, a ton of underclassmen and a lot of juniors that are going to be returning. So just want to get him reps and let Kyle Reese kind of figure out his team and what he's got back there.
Ball's loose, and CT's got it.
Yeah, another poor snap there, and Kai Ilayla just kind of bobbled it up and spilled it in the backfield, and Cherokee Trail's going to hop on it and get possession about midfield.
So unfortunately, those turnovers have kind of come at key times for this offense. You had first and goal late in the second quarter, a turnover, moved pretty deep into CT territory in the third quarter, turned it over, and they're on a fourth down, 3 to go.
Well, it's interesting because Kai has been pretty clean passing the ball. He hasn't really, you know, thrown for any interceptions or.
Nate Gay again, a long touchdown run to put the cherry on top tonight for Cherokee Trail. 49 yards to the end zone.
Yeah, so patient from Nate Gay. Just kind of ran up to the tackles. The space opened up and in between them. Didn't get there too soon, and the hole opens up, and he's gone. Looks like maybe another injury on the play here. But many of the turnovers for this Overland Trailblazers teams have come snapping the ball and little fumbles and such. So it hasn't really been a quarterback being careless type deal. You could argue maybe his hands have been a little careless in catching those snaps, but just a little bit of miscommunication. I think they're snapping the ball earlier than he anticipates, a little bit high for him, even though he's a tall quarterback. So, you know, mistakes that you can really iron out with just more practice and a little more communication and not really slander on Kai Ilayla himself.
Well, there's an injured Overland defender down. That is Jaheim Roper, who had an interception earlier. He's had some big runs on offense tonight and being helped off with the assistance of some of his coaches. And you certainly hope that the injury is minor and something he can bounce back from quick. He's a senior. He's got one game left in his high school career next week down at Doherty and helped off the field here.
Well, we always hope for the best with all these kinds of injuries, but, you know, a real bright spot on this Overland team, and just with one more game remaining in the Overland career, you hope that he can suit up for it.
So Nate Gay, his second long touchdown scamper of the night, first came from 65 yards out, that one from 50 yards out. So he's over the century mark on the ground this evening. Fishback sends the extra point right down the boulevard. It is 32-0 CT. inside of 11 minutes left to play in this fourth quarter. And well, Nate Gay, a junior this year, figures to be one of the top tailbacks in the area as a senior next year.
Sure, I mean, there's going to be a bigger opportunity for him on this Cherokee Trail team as so much of his peers move on to play at either the next level or you know, graduate from the school. But I mean, we're looking at 32-0 for this Cherokee Trail team, and they're missing arguably their best player in Sam Hart. And you just got to wonder how the big tight end in the Ohio State commit would change things, and you know, what kind of offense and team we're looking at moving forward in the playoffs if he's healthy for it. And that, I guess, is the question here on a Friday, is what kind of injury is it, and will he be healthy for next week's matchup?
Well, he had two catches for 72 yards in the win over Grandview last week. And
a relatively quiet game for him.
Yeah, but he's made some big plays on defense. The only touchdown CT had against Cherry Creek earlier this year was a Sam Hart strip sack for a touchdown. And they certainly want his services for the postseason on both sides of the football next week. That kick will bounce into the end zone for a touchback. And Overland will set up shop at the 20-yard line, trailing 32-0. Well, CT did all that work to get down inside the 10, turned it over on downs, their first possession of the second half, and then Nate Gay says enough of that from 50 yards out, one play to the end zone.
Yeah, Nate Gay just merciless back there and kind of punches in the nail in the coffin. You know, that might have already happened a little bit ago, but it just doesn't really bode well for Overland kind of pushing back here. This energy has been zapped from this offense, and the defense isn't faring any better.
Inside handoff to Khalil Ali Fisher. And down he goes to the 26-yard line. Ali Fisher, big tailback, 6 feet, 185 pounds. Saw him make some plays on defense earlier for Overland. Got a stable of guys, do the Trailblazers, that can run the ball effectively.
Yeah, you never know which one they're going to really go with. And if that's more just a game time decision or just game flow, maybe.
The option pitch out to Ali Fisher, and he's tripped up just shy of a first down. Mentioned Kyle Reese in his first season at the helm of this Overland Trailblazer football program, trying to turn it around. It has been a rough go of late. Overland has not had a winning season since 2014, haven't won a game since September of last year, and certainly with no spring ball and limited fall camp leading up to the season with all the question marks surrounding it this year. Reese said the most challenging thing since he took the job is just hasn't spent as much time as he would have liked to with his guys on the field this year. Christopher Lindsay gets loose, delivers a stiff arm, and out of bounds he goes inside the 30-yard line. And there's another guy who will be coming back next year. The junior Lindsay scampers inside the 30-yard line of Cherokee Trail.
Yeah, it might have been the biggest play of the night there for Overland. Jack Love, the backup quarterback, makes the stop and catches him in the backfield. Took a nasty stiff arm from Lindsay, who kind of saw the replacement quarterback as food, maybe. And Overland pushes back into that place that's been so dangerous for them near that red zone for Cherokee Trail.
Now the screen pass complete to CeCe, but he had to dive to catch that football, so he only gets one. Yeah, well, no. You just look at everything that they have coming back, and there's going to be big shoes to fill at quarterback with Elayla graduating, but Jameel Humphrey comes back, Ali Fisher comes back, Lindsay comes back, Tekel Roberson, CeCe, most notably there on offense for Overland, and well, with hopefully a lot more time on the field with his guys, this can be an Overland team that competes a little more in Centennial League action next year. CeCe shakes a tackle, scoots into the red zone, and picks up a first down to the 17.
Well, I think that's something we can expect from them next year, is to be a little more competitive, maybe get at least, you know, one win in Kyle Reese's second year. Just has a little more time to work with his guys, and like you're pointing out, the youth on this team is incredible, even on the defensive ends, with, you know, guys like Sir Joyner and and Curtis Bunton. You know, they bought players all over the place that are just going to age into their roles and kind of lock it down for the next 2 or 3 years.
Another red zone trip for Overland. See if they can put it all together and cross the goal line. Ali Fisher on the inside handoff. Picks up a couple of yards. The ankle tackle made by Mason Maddox, who's been all over the field for this Cougar defense tonight. And you have to give credit to Cherokee Trail's defense. We mentioned the incredible turnaround they've had here this season. Gave up 101 points the first two games. Less than 20 per game in their last three, and they've all been victories. This team goes as its defense goes, and well, it looked like they're going to win their fourth straight game.
Well, they've proven that they can, you know, score points on anybody, you know, regardless of how good of a defense they're playing. It's their own defense that's sort of the asterisk or the factor, as we see another bobbled snap and what's going to look like another Cherokee Trail recovery. So it's the same old story, Chris.
That's really unfortunate.
I think that's four turnovers from fumbled snaps.
Brennan Lance, a linebacker, picked up the loose ball there, and that is four turnovers, and all of them have come after success. You know, it's not like Overland has had a bad drive and thrown a pick a couple of plays in. I mean, they have had these impressive drives where they have worked in the CT territory, sometimes into the red zone, and yeah, they just have not been able to play clean football when they get towards that goal line. So CT's offense gets back to work. Nate Gay, a couple of long touchdowns tonight. And a 5-yard run there as we move inside of 7 minutes. Fourth quarter here at the Stutler Bowl. Penalty marker down late after the play. And while the officials figure it out, we'll talk some Centennial League football. Eagle Crest, Cherry Creek tomorrow. We had a chance to see both of those teams earlier this season. Eagle Crest had a dramatic week two win over Grandview, where they went for two and the lead late in the game, and the gamble paid off for Sean Marsh and company. And if there's a team on paper that can hang with Cherry Creek, it's probably Eagle Crest. But coming off of not playing the last couple of weeks with some of the COVID issues, it's going to be really tough to beat Dave Logan and company.
Yeah, and we had the pleasure of actually watching Cherokee Trail take on Cherry Creek in the second week of Centennial League football. And so we're familiar with that Cherry Creek team and how they kind of match up against another roster that we're viewing here tonight, and a talented team leading 32-0. But Cherry Creek, the defending regional state champions, so going to be a tall order for Eagle Crest, and I think it's going to come down to them playing consistently and not just breaking out for big plays, something that they're incredibly good at with all their athletes, but playing a little more cerebral and consistent football for four quarters.
Pierce on the fly sweep. Out of bounds right near the 45-yard line. Well, Julian Hammond, their outstanding quarterback, signed to play basketball at the University of Colorado earlier this week. So it's official. He will be headed to Boulder to play basketball. We thought that, you know, maybe he'd be a guy that would explore playing football at the next level, but Colorado, their basketball program, they envision him as a superstar there in the Pac-12 in the very near future.
Yeah, sure. And we've seen commitments, you know, all over the place. We saw Miles Purchase.
How about that? The Cyclones.
Yeah, committing to Iowa State.
Yeah.
And I mean, he's one of the top players in the state of Colorado, so it's going to be interesting to see him match up against a very talented, very athletic, and large Eagle Crest team tomorrow. And keeping an eye on that one.
Nate Gay dropped a couple of yards shy of the midfield stripe, but it's 3rd and 2 for CT. Cougars led this game 25-0 at halftime, and they have added a touchdown to their lead here in the second half. And the starting quarterback, Jaden Levine, still out there. And it looks like Overland may have jumped off sides, which would give CT a first down.
Yeah. Certainly did look like Jaden Levine got another guy.
Well, let me ask you this. Eagle Crest sitting out the last couple of weeks, and I know they were probably limited in what they could do together with the COVID issues at the school, but does it help them having a little more rest and maybe a little more time to prepare for Cherry Creek? Or do you see that as a game where they might have to shake off some rust early?
No, I don't really see them as shaking off too much rust. They're too good for that. And, you know, how it really may help them is no...
That throw over the middle is knocked away. Burke, the intended receiver, and Valden Thomas, his second pass breakup tonight.
What I was going to get at, Chris, is that there's no scouting that Dave Logan can do. And, you know, such a successful head coach and defending champion, we expect, you know, him to be really involved and engaged in scouting his opponents week to week, seeing what their tendencies are, what they like to run, and where they're at currently. A couple weeks off due to COVID, and a little bit of mystery over there for Eagle Crest, and might bode well for them in the rest factor, in the mystery, in all kinds of ways against an incredibly talented Cherry Creek team.
Levine throws on the run. Sturbis holds on. Nice catch. Alex Sturbis down to the 27-yard line. Had a long touchdown reception in the first half. And this is a guy that still isn't on the roster that we've been given. And he's been a late add to the varsity club.
He's sneaky
this
out
season,
there.
But he's turned out to be a hidden gem for Joe Johnson and company.
Yeah, I mean, he's been sort of quiet and hidden even tonight, but he's got a touchdown on the day, and, you know, when they have thrown it his way, he's secured the football and a couple really large gains for them, so.
Nate Gay powers through the middle and keeps the pile going with him inside the 20, down near the 18-yard line, right near another first down. Well, the Cougars, I'm sure they don't want to see Cherry Creek again, and if they keep winning games, they probably will. But what can you take away from the way they played the last four games of the season compared to when they saw Cherry Creek back in week two?
Well, they've certainly figured out the defensive end of the ball. You know, we talked about, you know, giving up 100 points in two games. You're not going to win a lot of football matches when you're giving up that many points. But, you know, since then, they've played, you know, really consistently and well on the defensive end of the game. And Cherry Creek has had a couple of scares in recent weeks where, you know, games closer than maybe we would expect from them. So.
Well, we're inside of 5 minutes in this fourth quarter. The ninth-ranked Cougars of Cherokee Trail, they'll win their fourth straight game. It'll be their first four-game winning streak since the start of the 2018 season when they reeled off six straight. And it will be their sixth straight year with a win over the Overland Trailblazers, who will try and close the season with some crescendo next week down at Doherty.
Certainly, we hope they can get, you know, a first win on the season. Hate to see any team go winless, but
I think Kyle Reese, where he's come from, and just in talking to him earlier this week, he knows what it takes to turn around a program, and it's going to be a process here at Overland. It's not going to happen overnight. It's not going to happen in one season. Maybe won't happen in two seasons, but when he gets his blueprint all over this program, you can bet that the Trailblazers are going to be a force in the Centennial League.
Certainly. You look at some of the programs that he's coached at previously, Valor Christian and Cherry Creek, those are the top two two undefeated teams in Colorado right now, and the top two teams respectively in all of Colorado.
Levine hit as he throws, and incomplete, looking for Pierce in the back of the end zone, and Demarius Davis has had a nice game. He knocked down the quarterback as he let go of that football. Now it's fourth and six down at the 13, and it looks like Joe Johnson will keep his offense out there.
Now he's been confident in them all night. I'm trying to remember after that first possession if they've punted since. They've definitely gone for a couple that didn't turn out their way and turned it over on downs, but mostly have converted on third and just avoided punting for more or less the entirety of the last three quarters.
Cougars need to get inside the 8-yard line for a new set of downs. Gay is the feature back, a wide 2x2 set for Jaden Levine, who's tossed a few touchdowns tonight. Tight pocket, throws on the run to the end zone, catch made, touchdown, no! He couldn't hold on. Incomplete. And Burke dropped the football at the last moment.
He had an outstanding defensive play to, I think the ball was near in his hands and it got stripped out as he came down.
So another fourth down stop in the red zone for Overland's defense. And when you're trying to rebuild a program and you're going through a rebuilding season like Kyle Reese and this Trailblazer team is, you take away the silver linings, and a couple of fourth down stops against a good offense tonight is something to be proud about heading into what will be the final week of practice next week.
Definitely, and we've seen it from Kyle Reese when we were on this side of the field and they got a stop against Cherokee Trail. He was hyped up, down 25 points, high-fiving his team, getting in their face, trying to get them back engaged into the game.
Humphrey on the fly sweep, steps out of bounds around the 15-yard line and gains two. Well, Overland, with a little more than 4 minutes left on this fourth quarter clock, I mean, they would love to march down the field and finally put one in here.
It would really feel like a small victory in and of itself, correct?
Injured CT defender down. And that is Michael Hemingway, who had a fumble recovery back in the first half. Promising junior defensive back. Looks to be some more cramping.
Yeah, grabbed his leg there in pain as he went down, so you hope he'll be all right for next week's matchup. Don't have who they're going to be playing next week, but that's something that we should see as soon as Sunday, I believe it is.
Well, Hemingway able to slowly jog off the field on his own power, which is a great sign. Certainly would like his services for the postseason next week.
Obviously.
The CT offense back to work. New quarterback in the game, Kamari Owens, a sophomore, perhaps the quarterback of the future here at Overland. Just a sophomore getting some time late in this game. Kai Ilela's night is done, it appears.
Yeah, a tough night for him in the sense of I don't think he got as many opportunities as he'd like with all the turnovers and the poor snaps. Speaking of poor snaps.
Another poor snap. It's going to be a safety or a touchdown. And it'll be a safety. Put two more on the scoreboard for CT. And the issues between center and quarterback, no matter who's back there, continue tonight for this Overland team. And I mean, it has just been the, and I don't mean to sound cliche in any way, but it has just been the little things that have plagued Overland in a big way tonight.
Yeah, it's almost not even really been what Cherokee Trail has done for them. I don't want to discredit them, and I know they've definitely been forcing Overland into a lot of pressure to make these mistakes, but it's really on their own volition, poor snaps, little bobbles and fumbles, and even a player like that, it almost exonerates the quarterback, Kai Iolela, who, you know, he could be upset with himself that maybe he shouldn't have dropped some of them and shouldn't have fumbled some of the snaps, but, you know, two plays in and his replacement is getting the ball snapped over his head and the same thing's happening. So really doesn't appear to be the issue of the quarterback at this point.
So after the safety, Overland will kick the ball back. Interesting thing on these after safeties, you can either punt the ball or you can kick it off a tee. And it looks like Overland is opting to kick it off the tee.
It's been a lot of short kicks in this game and really good starting field position for both of these teams, actually.
Ilela, guess his night wasn't done, sends it away, and that'll be returned across the midfield stripe down to about the 47-yard line. With a little more than 3.5 minutes left to play in this game. It was Caleb Davis on the return. Now I think we'll get a chance to see some of the backups for CT. Well, Mason Thompson, 6'2 quarterback, will take the reins. Well, maybe he won't. It'll be Logan Brook, rather, at quarterback. Thompson was in the huddle. Both backup Jaden Levine and Nate Gay, one of the few starters still in there, bruises down to the 40-yard line. It almost looks like it hurts more to tackle Nate Gay
than it hurts him to get tackled.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's got that effect on people where when they hit him, you know, he doesn't really go down. He kind of just bounces off or pushes them to the ground almost. And it's almost taken two guys on every play to bring him down.
So at 2nd and 5, Gay has had a big night, a 65-yard touchdown run and a 50-yard touchdown run.
Might be a helmet or equipment issue, as the referee told number 21, who we don't have on.
We don't have.
Might be wearing a new jersey today.
The mystery man.
Yeah, he said, get off my field and go fix that equipment.
Inside of 3 minutes. CT on the verge of their fourth straight victory. We do not have a number 12 for CT either, so we get into this portion of the game where maybe some of the JV guys are seeing time. They don't have official varsity roster numbers. That young man does pick up a first down for CT. We'd love to give him some credit if we had the resources to do that. But certainly that won't take away from the moment for that young man. It's on video. Just mute us. And
record over yourself.
He'll get it again. And he breaks free inside the 30. Takes a hard pop down at the 26-yard line. And the PA announcer doesn't know either. Number 12. And there is another injured Overland Trailblazer being attended to late in this game. Playoff brackets and matchups are coming out Sunday. CT will more than likely be in. Doesn't really matter in regards to getting to the playoffs in that contest tomorrow. Eagle Crest and Cherry Creek will be in regardless, but the winner of that game will likely be the number one overall seed. And it is a shortened playoff field this season. They're letting in just 8 teams.
Yeah, so a lot of teams that are kind of right on the bubble and are pretty competitive in this Centennial League not going to be, you know, present in their normal spot playing later into the wintertime.
Cherokee Trail made it to the second round of the postseason last year and lost a tight game to Fairview High School out of Boulder, 36-34.
That was number 8, Malachi Sims, who is leaving the field. Gets up on his own power and going to walk the trainer over to the sideline. He's been an absolute stud on the defensive end, and maybe the scoreboard doesn't really reflect that, trailing by 34 points, but one of the big bright spots on this team and someone who, you know, really might look to play at the next level.
Out of the injury timeout. This offense engineered by Logan Brook, the backup quarterback, as he tosses one to the sideline, and that gets there. That is complete inside the 15-yard line. That would look like a dying quail there, but it made it out to Gage Gordon, the backup tight end.
Yeah, I think for Joe Johnson here, would love to, you know, put one more in the end zone and kind of just cement this great feeling of a dominant victory and just kind of get his team as prepared and firing on all cylinders moving into the postseason.
And as we mentioned, Overland, this will wrap up the regular season for them, but they are taking advantage of the option to play a seventh and final game, and they'll visit Doherty next week as the Trailblazers take a timeout inside of 2 minutes.
Yep, both teams still just want to make sure that they get their teams playing correct. Despite the large point differential in this one, no one's going to give up or kind of call it early. Make sure their teams are playing until the final whistle and ensuring a clean victory. Here comes the Cherokee Trail offense back on onto the field to execute what seems to be probably their last drive.
Yeah, probably the last few plays here.
Well, unless, of course, Overland goes the entire length of the field and then fumbles it near the 20-yard line.
Certainly hope that the Trailblazers can make those minor adjustments and get back rolling. I mean, they scored 39 points a week ago, and their defense collects another tackle for loss here.
Well, they got it right. Shut that one down.
Donovan Sanders was dropped by Khalil Ali Fisher for a loss of one. Number 12 is back in there for CT. Logan Brook, the 6'2 quarterback, gives it to number 12. Oh my goodness, he runs over number 21. the two guys that aren't on the roster, so it's only appropriate.
Right, that's just our luck.
Appropriate.
I mean, we don't know who number 12 on this Cherokee Trail our team is, but he sure has the love of his sideline every time he gets a snap.
Give credit to 21 in black. He made a nice stop there. Looked like he was going to get run over, and he brought him down with him. All right, so this could be the final play of the game inside of 30 seconds. Brennan Lance is the lone setback here, and CT will take a delay of game. Penalty marker down. We're just going to keep on going tonight from the Stutler Bowl. Well, I wonder why they did that.
Yeah, they had
instead of maybe just taking a knee.
Well, they have a timeout remaining too, so if they wanted to just, you know, draw something up and give their backups maybe a shot at the end zone. Cherokee Trail sideline and fan base all socially distanced tonight. They're all standing and ready to make it back to the parking lot.
Taking a look at the Spirit Squad for Cherokee Trail.
Obviously a little different environment in high school football going on. Not maybe the same spirit as we discussed the Spirit Squad and take a look maybe at some of the fan base and parents out here, but obviously very interesting circumstances creating this sort of environment here at the Stutler Bowl.
Hats off to our crew tonight, Chris Johnson, our cameraman, and Brian Roth back of the truck. That'll be the final play tonight from the Stutler Bowl, and the CT Cougars close the 2020 shortened regular season on a four-game winning streak, and they will be in the postseason a week from tonight. Overland, they end their regular season 0-6, but they'll have another chance at a 2020 victory next week as they head down south to Doherty. Well, obviously the big game around here is Eagle Crest Cherry Creek tomorrow, but your thoughts on a Cherokee Trail team that, after starting 0-2 for the first time in 11 years, was able to turn it around, and they've got some momentum headed into the postseason.
Well, it was a convincing victory. I mean, they win 34-0. The defense holds up, mostly the offense clicking and firing on what appears to be all cylinders while they're down, you know, a huge part of this Cherokee Trail engine in Sam Hart. I mean, he's someone who's going to be playing in the FBS, Ohio State, 6'5", and he's got 7 touchdowns on the year. So there's just so much that a player like that brings. And even when they played Cherry Creek earlier in the season, they had him lining up on the defensive end. He got a strip fumble. So there's so much that a player like that brings when playing against the highest level talent, like the Eagle Crest, like the Cherry Creeks. So for them to make a deep run, I think that's going to be a bit of necessity, but just an outstanding performance from Cherokee Trail tonight here from the Stutler Bowl.
Well, that wraps up our coverage here on Cherry Creek TV on YouTube. The Cougars take down the Trailblazers tonight by a final of 34-0 at the Stutler Bowl in Greenwood Village, Colorado. Thanks so much for watching. For JP Hiraoka and our entire crew, my name's Chris Sylvester, saying so long, and thanks for being with us this evening. CT 34, Overland 0, our final score. Good night, everybody.